So cross-legged with your hips lifted, preferably to keep the hips higher than the knees. Grounding through your two sit bones, be tall in the spine. Let the length go all the way up from the top of your spine through the back of your head, crown of your head opening to the earth, hands on the knees, resting. And we'll softly close the eyes here if that's comfortable. And on your own, count down from 10 today in your head by yourself, using this 10 count to drop you down to the heart space. Letting gravity push down from our head space to the heart space and the belly space where we want to be present for practice today. You'll know if you're returning to the head space because thoughts will reappear. Don't judge yourself, but just use the countdown to return down to the heart space. Trying to stay present and connected to your body, and then grounding, so connecting to the earth, the oneness that we all are, connectedness, aliveness. Take a big inhale to lengthen the spine a little bit more, and then maybe an open mouth exhale, sigh it out. And flutter the eyes open. We'll start with some neck movements. So just let the neck go in circles all the way around as much as feels comfortable. Use your breath with the movement. Hi, those that just joined us. And then we'll take our two hands to clasp the fingers behind the head. Now you don't have to do this if it's too much, but we're gonna drop our chin down and over to the right, and then use the pressure from the hands on the back of your head to add some weight. Keep the spine long, but we're pulling the chin down over to the right. Release back up to center, and then take the same thing on the left. Let the chin drop first over to the left, and then add some pressure with your hands, feeling that stretch on the upper right side. And then release those hands, take them behind us now. Opening the opposite way, grab the hands or the elbows, pull the shoulders back to feel that chest space open up. Maybe it feels natural to lift the chin, gaze up, really opening through the heart space and the throat. All right, release out of that. We'll come into a spinal twist. So if you have your hips up on that block, we'll have to take that out from under us. Turn up the music just a little bit. We'll go into a spinal twist. So inhale, reach your hands high. And then exhale, twist to the right. Let the right hand drop behind you. Left hand lands on the right knee. Inhale to find length. Reach up through your crown. And then exhale, let the chin fall over to the right. Gaze goes back. All right, inhale back to center. Your next exhale, take it over to the left. Use your breath. Exhale, let the left hand drop behind you. Right hand hooks onto the knee or anywhere on the thigh. Don't let that back go drop backwards. Keep the spine right on top of the hips. And then inhale back to center. All right, take those legs out on your mat. We're gonna roll onto the back for a moment.
Can you hear the music at all? Medium? No, I'm trying to turn it on. Okay, it should start.
Okay, Supta Baddha. Lay on your back. Come to butterfly pose. Let the insides of your feet come together. Let the knees fall out. You can rock side to side a little bit here. Let the hips really open tall through your spine. So maybe lift the shoulder blades up the mat a little bit. We won't be here for long, just opening the hips, maybe adding the weight of your hands onto your thighs to drop the knees out to the side. And then we'll come into a happy baby. Grab the outsides of both feet. Pull those knees down towards the earth. Again, you can rock side to side a little bit here. Really opening the hips. Where are they at today at the beginning of the practice? And then shoot the heels up towards the ceiling, just straight into the legs. We're just gonna shake out the heel, the feet here. Get the ankles flowing, reverse one flow. And maybe take some ankle circles. Getting into the feet. All right, so we're gonna cross the right leg over the left leg, coming into an eagle pose on our back. So the right leg crosses over the left leg, right elbow crosses under left elbow. So your spine tries to stay on the mat. Try to keep your knees and elbows in one line. You exhale, crunch right knee, right elbow, give it a tap, and inhale, find length. At your own pace, warming up the core with eagle arms and legs. Exhale, crunch, inhale, find length. Use that ujjayi breathing. If you feel like you're building a lot of internal heat, then open up, exhale to let it out. When you're in that crunch position, pull the knees and elbows high to the sky. Really feel your whole core engaging. And then you find length as you lower back down. Keep going. You can drop the heels all the way to the mat to get into that low core. Last one, hold it in that crunch position, knee to elbow, right knee to elbow, hold up. Lift your hips off the mat, shoulders off the mat. And then release arms and legs. Take your heels to the mat. Cactus the arms. Windshield wiper the knees side to side. We're going to do the same thing left side. So wrap that left knee around right knee. Try to hook the calf or the foot to the back of your right calf. And then right elbow is under left elbow this time. So your left knee and elbow will crunch together. Exhale, crunch up, arch your spine. Inhale, long. Exhale, crunch. Same thing, core workout on the other side. Really reach up, feel that whole core engaging. And then as your heels lower to the mat, feel that low core doing work. Using your breath, your focus, staying in the present, feeling everything. Last couple. All right, roll release. Same thing, cactus arms, windshield wiper, the legs, the knees, just a couple times. All right, and then from here, we're just gonna roll onto our bellies. Just roll on over. Let those hands come under the shoulders. Press the tops of the feet into the mat. We're just gonna push up into a nice spinal arch, releasing the abs. You can higher or low, sorry, Go as high as you want, either forearms or pressing hands to mat. Release the abs. And then we'll lower the chest down. Press back to a quick child's pose. Letting the spine counter arch, send the hips back towards the heels. Settle into the hips, maybe rock side to side a couple of times. And then come up to tabletop. We'll take a few cat cows. Inhale, drop the belly, gaze goes up. Exhale, arch the spine with a heavy, heavy. Really exaggerate these cat cows. So bend the elbows. Maybe even adding some lateral movement. Sometimes it feels good to push those hips over to the right and the left. Maybe even adding some neck stretch. Just make it your practice. Okay, sit back onto those shins. And then we're gonna open the bottoms of the feet just a little bit more as we get into the shoulders. So pop onto those toes. Add as much weight as you want. Coming on or off the feet at any time. And then we'll take the back of the wrist together. Press the wrist together. This is good to counter all those down dog poses. Let the core be engaged so we're still active here. Pull the belly button up and in. And then let the tops of the feet come to the mat. Walk your hands behind you, fingers face forward. On an inhale, push the hips up to the sky. Let your head drop back. Again, opening through that chest. And we lower back to the shins, come forward through tabletop, make your way to down dog. First down dog of class, so walk it out. Pedal the feet, anything that feels natural, comes, whatever movement comes to your body, just let it go. The things we do want to cover in down dog is nice, stable, sharp shoulders. Spread those fingers wide. Feel like you have a nice grip on the mat with the hands. Let the gaze be back between the legs. Heels don't have to touch the mat, but heels are reaching for the mat. And then from here, move your big toes to touch. Down dog with your big toes to touch. Inhale, right leg high to the sky. Exhale, knee to chest. Do not drop the foot. Hold the knee into the chest. Inhale, the leg long. Same thing for four more. Exhale, knee to chest. Don't drop the foot. We're just moving through this transition. Inhale, leg high. Exhale, crunch, knee to chest. Don't drop the foot. Pull the knee as high as you can. Fourth one. Inhale, the leg high. All right, the next time you come forward, lizard pose, drop the right foot on the outside of the right pinky. Drop the left knee. For this lizard pose, roll onto the outer edge of the right foot. We're gonna keep pressed up with the left hand under the left shoulder. And then if it's in your practice today, opening the quad on the left leg. So reaching your left heel towards your body, reaching on with the right foot to grab it, or staying in lizard pose. All right, release the left foot back to the mat. We're going to come to a modified side plank. So your right foot's going to come halfway down your mat. You're going to land on the outer edge of the left foot, and you're pressing into the mat with your left wrist. Right hand goes high to the sky. Modified side plank.
So keep that right foot there. We're going to go into a stretch. Oops.
All right, now drop your hips down to the floor, and you'll feel the stretch on the outer leg, the left side, and up these obliques and rib cage. Press your left hand into the mat to keep lifting that chest. Feel the stretch on the outside of the body. All right, come back through plank. Step your right foot back to meet the left. And we'll just step back to down dog. Bring those big toes to touch again. This time, inhale, left leg high to the sky. You do this 5 times. Exhale, knee to chest. This is a core workout. You pull your belly button up and in as high as you can with every exhale. You even arch your spine towards the ceiling, trying to push up through those shoulder blades. When you inhale, the foot high to the sky, try to keep the hips square to the mat. Last one. We'll meet in lizard pose. Take that left foot on the outside of the left pinky. Drop the right knee. Roll onto the outer edge of the left foot. We're going to keep the chest lifted in lizard pose today. Press your right hand into the mat under that shoulder. Turn your chest over to the left a bit so you're kind of gazing to the left. Chest goes to the left. Reach up and grab the right foot for quad stretch. All right, release out of it. We come to that modified side plank. Lift up onto the outer edge of the right foot. Bring your left foot to the mid mat. Reach that left hand high to the sky. And then settle the hips down to the mat. Breathe into the outer edge of that right leg and into this side body here. All right, roll over back to plank pose. Step left foot back to knee right, and we'll lower down all the way onto our bellies, going as slow as you can. Keep the elbows into the body, practicing that chaturanga. We'll lower all the way down to the belly. Let the feet go long, we'll inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, press through tabletop to down dog. Bend the knees, look at the space between the hands, bottom of your next exhale, walk sit or hop to the front of your mat. When you get there, inhale, half lift, shine the heart forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, all the way to standing. Hands come overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center, down by your side. We'll bring the big toes to touch, setting up for chair pose.
So let there be some space between the heels.
Bend the knees, inhale the hands forward, chair pose. Sink those hips back like you're trying to find a chair behind you. And then pull your low ribs in, tuck your tailbone down to the earth. Exhale, twist to the right, let the outside of the left elbow move onto the right knee. Press into the hands, add some spinal twists, pull the belly button up and in, gaze goes over your right shoulder. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, twist to the left, same thing, left side. Press those palms together. One day the thumbs will come to the center of the chest.
Gaze over to the left. Nice job. Inhale back to center. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift, shine the heart forward. Exhale, plant the hands, step back so you can take it through your first chaturanga or meet me in down dog, skip it completely. Exhale through that half push up, inhale to the up dog or cobra pose. Exhale, roll over the toes, down dog. All right, we'll inhale, right leg high to the sky. Exhale, plant the foot, warrior one this time. So let the back toes be out at an angle. Sweep the hands forward. Deep bend in the front knee. Drop that right knee out to the right. Exhale, grab the hands behind us, setting up for your humble warrior. Clasp the hands or the elbows. Inhale, open that chest. Exhale, humble your warrior. Fall to the inside of the right thigh. Pull your hands up and over towards the front of the room. Inhale back to warrior one. So sweep those hands back forward. See if you can be strong in those legs. And then we exhale, open warrior two. So your front knee can stay where it was. Cartwheel the left hand towards the back of the room and your toes will probably be out at more of an angle. Opening the hips for warrior two. Feeling the burn in the legs, keeping the strong warrior two legs. Inhale, reverse warrior. Left hand down, right hand up. Exhale, extended side angle, right elbow, right knee, left hand reaches up and over. One more time, reverse warrior. Inhale back, keep that strong bend in the front knee. And then exhale all the way to half moon pose. You're balancing right hand, right foot, left hand and left foot reach up to the sky. Last pose before you take it through your vinyasa. Ground through that right foot, reach up with the left fingertips. Maybe you come onto your fingers of the right hand, keep that chest lifted. All right, bend the right knee, plant the hands on the mat. Let your left foot land really far back, shoot your right foot back to meet the left. Exhale through chaturanga or all the way to your belly. Inhale, up dog or cobra pose. Exhale, down dog. Always have option to take rest in down dog or child pose. Inhale through the nose. Exhale with the open mouth, let out some of the heat. Inhale, left foot goes high to the sky. Try to keep the hips square to the mat. Exhale, warrior one, plant the foot between the hands. Let the hands come forward. Track that left knee out so you can see your big toe on the left side. Hips square to the front of the room. So pull your left hip back into its socket. Exhale, grab those hands behind you or the elbows. Inhale, open the chest. Let your gaze lift if that feels nice. Open the throat. Exhale, humble your warrior. Let everything drop to the inside of the left leg without pushing your left hip out to the left. Keep those strong warrior one legs. Let the head relax. Don't have to hold up the head with any tension in the neck. Inhale back, warrior one. Sweep the hands forward. Use your breath. Exhale, open it up, warrior two. Feeling those legs. Moving through two warrior poses. So now the hips are pulling out. Inhale, reverse warrior. Left hand high, right hand down the leg, or let the right hand drop around the low back. Exhale, extended side angle. Left elbow, left knee, right hand reaches up and over. Inhale, back to reverse warrior. Last time. Exhale, your balancing pose, half moon, balance on your
Left foot, left hand this time. Reach up with those right fingertips. Open your chest to the right side of the room. Ground through your left foot. Nice job. Keep going. Come up onto the fingers of the left hand. Use the chest core to lift. And then bend the left knee. Plant the hands. Take it through your vinyasa, knowing that we're going to take a rest in child's pose. So very intentional with your three breaths as you move through a strong chaturanga, up dog, down dog. Then let those knees go wide. Heels back towards, or hips back towards the heels. Take a child's pose this time. Bend the elbows, bring the hands to clasp overhead. Getting more into the front of the shoulders and the triceps here. Keep those hips sending back towards the heels to find length in the spine. All right, and slowly lift up. Open the hips a little bit before we flow again. So let's come right to frog pose. Reposition yourself long ways on your mat. You're gonna bring your knees as wide as you can, propping yourself up with those hands. Press the insides of the shins into the mat. Frog pose is really intensive, especially if you haven't been here before. So move slow. And take whatever frog pose is calling your body today. So that means you can wiggle the hips forwards and backwards until you find a spot, or you can lift and lower the chest, supporting yourself on your forearms or your hands. You'll find lots of different angles to breathe into the hips. Find one that feels nice, and practice holding it for 10 full inhales and exhales. Trying to stay as present as you can. Pose, so don't let that belly relax. Pull that core up and in. All right, we're going to slowly come out of it. It takes time to wiggle the knees back together. Go nice and slow. Use your hands, or the weight pressed into your hands to release that. And then let's come back to tabletop. Let's be in tabletop. All right, from tabletop, we're just going to bring our right knee out to the right. Bend the knee and take some hip circles here. Feel the rebound from that frog pose. You might feel the hips, the little tingling sensation, pretty open in the hip. And then tuck, or bring your right leg, shoot it back to the wall. Tuck your left toes, we'll come up to a three-legged down dog. Press your left heel to the mat, bend the right knee, open that hip in the air. You can take wild thing if that's in your practice today, flipping the right foot all the way to the mat or just hanging out in that three-legged down dog. Nice job. Press up through the hips, strong through the left hand, beautiful. Back to down dog, come all the way to down dog. We'll bring the right foot to the front of the mat, low lunge. Drop the back knee, we're gonna breathe into the front of the hip flexor first. Inhale, lift the chest. So to the stretch for a moment.
All right, bring these hands to the front of your mat. Plant them under your shoulders. You're gonna lift your back knee. Step your right foot back to meet the left. Plank pose, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up dog. Exhale down dog. We'll just drop to the knees so we can get that left side. We'll take from tabletop, we'll take left knee out to the side. Open those hips for the left hip. Still feeling that frog pose, feels pretty open. Couple hip circles. And then straighten into that left leg, three-legged dog, right side. Tuck the right toes. Inhale, lift the hips. High to the sky, stay here or bend the foot. Come all the way to wild thing. Make sure you have a nice stacked right wrist under right shoulder. Press through both heels to lift the hips. As you come back to center, let the left foot come all the way to low lunge. The left foot comes between the hands. Drop the back knee. Inhale, lift the chest. Open up the front of that right hip flexor. If you bring the chest back, pull your low belly in, you'll feel even more of a stretch there. Bring the hands to the mat, same thing, make your way back to down dog. Going through chaturanga, so lift the right knee. Step the left foot back to meet the right. Try to keep those hips low. Plank pose. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up dog, exhale down dog. We'll take it through one sunny, moving back and down dog. So bend the knees. Bottom of your next exhale, look at the space between your hands. Walk, step, or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, hop, lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up to standing. Hands come overhead. Exhale, hands through heart center, down by your side. Next inhale, hands go back overhead. Exhale, hinge at the hips, forward fold. Inhale, half lift, lengthen the spine. Exhale, plant the hands. That same exhale takes you all the way to half push-up, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. All right, we'll inhale, right leg high to the sky. Exhale, high lunge. Drop the right foot between the hands. Sweep the hands forward. You're on the ball of the left foot. Shoulders out of the ears. So maybe the palms are in to face each other to help rotate the armpits in a little bit. And then from here, we're gonna come up knee parallel, left knee parallel to the mat. Using that core. Back to high lunge. One more time, knee parallel to the mat. And then warrior three, kick that left heel back. Reach the hands forward. Hips square to the floor. Keep those hips square. Keep reaching through that left heel. You look like a capital T. All right, drop that left foot as far as you can back on the mat. We'll come to wide-legged horse fold. So turn those toes into a pigeon. Inhale, find length in the spine. Hands on the hips. Or hands out to the side. Exhale, forward fold. Try to come down with that straight spine. And then release the hands to the mat. Let your head come down. Nice pose to shake out the head. Shake out the neck. Pull the belly button up and in. Maybe roll the weight into the balls of the feet a little bit. See what it feels like to get those hips even higher. If your head's really far from the mat, walk those feet wider. Your head's touching the mat. Bring those feet closer together. All right, come back towards the front of your mat with the hands in the chest. We're gonna come to a wide pyramid pose. So pyramid pose, we usually have heel to heel alignment a little shorter, but we're gonna try wide today. So keep that foot really far back. Grab that prop if you have that block to lift that chest. Just think of it as an extension of your arm. So wide pyramid pose, inhale to find length in the spine. Exhale, fold over your right shin. Back toes are out at an angle. You're still heel to heel alignment, but wider than your normal pyramid pose. If you're feeling the heat, release the open mouth exhale. And then return to your dry breathing. All right, inhale, come back to lifting the chest, put the hands in the mat, step it back, take a good chaturanga, stand up dog, or we'll be in down dog. All right, inhale, left leg high to the sky. Exhale, knee to chest, plant the foot high, lunge, come up with the hands. We move through this pose two times. So inhale from my lunge. We inhale, lift that knee off the floor, that was pretty low. And then back to high lunge. Inhale, knee parallel to the floor. Exhale, shoot that right hip directly to the back of the room. Keep the hips square to the floor, warrior three. Hands reach forward. Big toe on the right side curls in towards the midline of the body. Grounding through that left foot. Core pulls up and in. Hard pose. Building strength. Drop the right foot really far down on the back of the mat. Wide legged forward fold. You'll curl your left toes in the face to the right. Make sure you're pigeon toed. Inhale, find length in the spine. Exhale, forward fold. Giving you a little bit of time again, wide legged forward fold. There are so many options here. You can grab the outside of the legs to pull your head closer to the mat. You can take a twist, spinal twist, left hand under your face, right hand up to the sky. Going on both sides. Or simply let gravity do the work. Just let your head reach towards the ceiling or the floor. Pull that belly button up and in, move the weight to the balls of the feet a little bit. All right, setting up for a wide pyramid pose. We turn to face the front of the mat. Keep those feet really wide. So heel to heel alignment, right toes out at an angle, but usually the pyramid pose would be about shorter, 3 to 4 feet. We're going to try long today. Inhale, find length in the spine. Exhale, fold over that left shin. All right, inhale to lift the chest. We're gonna come back to puppy pose. Just bring your left knee back to the mat. Drop your right knee. Keep the hips stacked over the knees. Walk the hands forward, puppy pose. I wanna stretch out the front of the shoulders. So let your forehead come back to the mat for puppy pose. It's really getting the front of those shoulders,
If you don't feel it, try to bring your hips more to stack over the knees and reach your hands forward. If it feels like it's pulling on the joints a little too hard, maybe bring the hands a little bit wider, bring some width across the top of your back to keep the shoulders out of the ears. And then walk your hands over to the right. We'll breathe into this side body stretch. Right hand is more for stability. In puppy pose, we're reaching over to the right. Really reach through the left fingertips. Sink back into that left hip socket. Walk the hands through center over to the left. Really reach with that right finger, or the right hand, as far as you can, not only up and over, or high to the room, but over to the left. Sink your hips back to the right. Head doesn't have to touch the mat. Head is just hanging out wherever it's comfortable. We're breathing into the side body. All right, come back through center, tabletop position, and then lift the hips, down dog. We're just gonna baby step to the front of the mat. Try to keep your hips as high as you can. Stay up on the balls of your feet. Try not to lift your hands off the mat. Keep those hips really high so your core is lifting here. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, forward fold. And inhale, reverse swan dive all the way to standing. All right, we're gonna do one last balancing pose here. Dancer's pose. So let's start by grounding into your left foot. We're gonna start at the base here. So ground into that left foot, kick up to kickstand with the right foot. Your left kneecap, pull it up and into the quad, but you're not hyperflexing that left leg, microbending the knee. All right, and then come into a quad stretch with the right foot, grabbing right foot with right hand. Your pelvis is neutral, low ribs pulled in. Inhale, left hand high to the sky, shoulder out of the ear. Inhale to find length, and exhale, dancer's pose. You think about kicking and then dropping the chest to reach that right hand or left hand forward like you're trying to shake someone's hand. Keep looking forward, wristies on something, not moving. If you fall out of it, come back in. We're in dancer's pose. Keep kicking. Feel the quad. Feel everything. The right shoulder gazes forward. All right, nice job. Release. Yeah, we held it for a little bit long. That's the fun part about it. Little added challenge. Kick out those feet. And then we'll find our stillness to do the same thing on the right side. Maybe an open mouth exhale. We're gonna hold it for the same amount of time. So move into it at your own pace. Key is to start at the base and then move up. So ground through that right foot. Feel strong in the right leg before you reach up to that quad stretch. When you're ready, inhale the right hand high to the sky. Moving at no one's pace but your own. Inhale to find length and exhale, you fold the chest forward. Keep up left foot, left hand. Kicking, feel that low spine arch. Keep kicking, pull that foot higher to the sky. Can you get the foot a little bit higher? Reach the hand a little bit farther forward. Ground through that right foot, microbend in the knee, keep kicking. All right, nice job, come out of it.
Mountain pose, top of your mat. Let's just get down to our bellies. Inhale those hands overhead. Exhale, hinge at the hips, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step back, take it through your last downward vinyasa. We'll meet in down dog. Come to pigeon pose, right side. So bring right knee to behind right wrist. Walk that left leg long down your mat. Inhale, lengthen the spine. And exhale, take pigeon pose. On your way down, you can roll that right thigh up and out to the right a little bit, creating room for the fold and creating space for the hip to stretch. We'll hold pigeon, same thing for about 5 to 10 breaths. Try and use your breath here to your advantage. Letting every exhale get you deeper into the stretch, releasing. Gently push up and we'll switch from right side to left side. So come all the way back to down dog. There might be some stretch in down dog we want to take before we go to pigeon pose on the left side. And left knee to behind left wrist, walk the right leg back. Inhale to lift the chest and then exhale. Pigeon pose. Maybe rolling that thigh, the left thigh out and up a little bit. Creating space. Pigeon pose is not in your practice. Feel free to take a supine. Figure four. Giving the same stretch. All right, from pigeon pose, we'll step that left foot back to meet the right. Just go to down dog, just to even it out on both sides. And then we're gonna make our way back to our bellies. So any in-between stretches before we come down to our mats to end practice, we'll start on our bellies with that shoulder stretch, bringing right arm out perpendicular from the mat. Press your left hand into the mat, turn it over the right shoulder. Let the left hip come to stack on top of the right hip. So maybe that involves bending that top knee, your left knee, and placing the foot behind the right leg. Let the head rest, and you're breathing into the front of the right shoulder. All right, slowly roll through center, find a moment of stillness, symmetry in the spine before you roll onto the other side. Sticking that left arm out. And then rolling over the left side, stack the right hip on top of the left this time. I'll add the nice spinal twist. Right hand supporting you by placing it in front of your face on the mat. Pushing a little bit into the twist. Inhale.
All right, come back to center, roll onto your backs.
When you get there, pull the knees into the chest.
Drop a little hug.
Side. And then I want to take Happy Baby one more time. Feel how your hips are much more open than they were 50 minutes ago when you did this stretch at the beginning of class. All that you released. Let the energy go out of the hips. Out of your entire body. And then from Happy Baby, we'll come to shoulder stand. So gain some momentum. Press those hands into the floor. You're gonna wanna wiggle those hips. Maybe it takes a few times to rock them off the mat up to the sky. Clasping your hands to your low back and wiggle those shoulders in. So you created a shelf. You can add some, you can move that weight into the hands that are supporting your low back. Yogi's choice for the legs. If shoulder stand is not in your practice, I would recommend just keeping the feet elevated towards the ceiling, maybe propping your hips up with a block or a pillow. Shoulder stand, keep pulling your core up and in. Chest pulls towards the chin. And then we'll run down to plow pose. Let the feet come overhead, touching the mat. Try to straighten into both legs in plow pose. Maybe you grab your hands together. Option for deckman's pose today. If you can wrap your knees around your ears, cutting off the sound. And then when you're ready, we'll roll out of whatever stretch you're in, all the way down to your mat. And at this time, taking any last stretches that are in your class today, anything that's calling your name, before we end in Shavasana. So whenever you're ready, let the legs go long. Let's roll out to the side. Gently close the eyes, tuck the chin down towards the chest. Left hand on heart, right hand on belly, or hands down by the side. Dedicating the next few minutes to yourself. Dropping down to the heart space. If you notice any thoughts entering the mind, again, we don't judge ourselves for having thoughts, for saying, oh, I'm supposed to be in Shavasana. I shouldn't be thinking right now. Don't be hard on yourself. Just let them go. Don't attach. Just smile and watch them leave. Welcome to Shavasana. Thank you.
You can invite the movement back into your body by wiggling your fingers and toes. Rock the head side to side, maybe flutter the eyes open. Noticing spaciousness around you. And then rolling over onto your favorite side, using the arm as a pillow. And gently pushing yourself up to a comfortable seated position. We'll meet sitting cross-legged facing the camera to end practice together. And now sweep those hands overhead, fingertips to touch. Exhale the thumbs to your forehead, that third eye center, bow the chin. Do your practice and all is good.